Welcome everyone to beautiful Sun City Anthem in Henderson, Nevada. We're about 20 minutes from the Las Vegas Strip. We're up here on the hill today looking at this listing that is actually the most expensive listing in Sun City. This home is 2,769 square feet, 3 bedrooms, 4 baths, listed for $1.228 million. Andrew, why is it so expensive? Well, for one, it's one of the larger models in Sun City. You see similar models to this that have a casita with them, and those are actually going to be the largest models in Sun City. This is going to be the step down from that at just about 2,800 square feet. So if you don't need that casita or necessarily the fourth bedroom, this would be the right one for you. But this one is all about the views. Views, views, views. We have canyon views. We have strip views. We have city views, we have sky views, we have it all. So we're gonna see that out back. So stay tuned to the end. You gotta see the views. That's what makes this house everything it is. Now you can find this house all over Sun City. They only use, you know, a handful of models throughout the 7,500 homes here. And, you know, I think there's about, I don't know, probably, gosh, I would have to count the models. I'm not even gonna speculate. I'll probably be way wrong, but you know, there's the same models you see throughout. So you can find this home all over Sun City, but you're not going to see it in this exact location with this lot. It's the outside is just ridiculous out back. So here you go. These are a 3-car garage here and a little courtyard. So you saw the mature landscape down the left side, not much going on. And then, yeah, this big open front courtyard with a gate that you can lock, a nice sturdy gate, plenty of room for table chairs if you like, and it just makes a nice grand entryway here. A little bit of a covered area there, and these two big glass security doors, and then your double front doors coming inside. And this home's been professionally staged as well. Really great decor. Everything matches very well, and it's just got a great feel to this home. Bright colors, properly placed mirrors. Yeah, some of that construction, you can see all new flooring throughout the entire home. About 5 or 6 inch baseboards down there, crown molding around, looks like at least this room. I'm not seeing it in the other rooms. Very tall ceilings, big open floor plan. This is going to be kind of your living area here, living room with your living area out here. We kind of have a hallway to the right and a hallway to the left. The way these Sun City models are mostly set up, it is a 55 plus community, and most of the homes are going to be 2 to 3 bedroom, and they're basically going to be separated. The primary bedroom will be on one side of the home, and the secondary bedroom will be on the other, and a lot of the setups. And it's just, you know, it's kind of a desired design for these homes. You know, again, they are retiree homes, so you're having guests in that other room and you keep them on the other side of the house. So it is a nice way they design them. So this one's gonna have bedrooms on the left and the primary on the right. And then I'll show you this third bedroom, which is very interesting. So as we come back here, this is going to be the first bedroom we see. Again, very nice, large bedroom with its own full bathroom. The full bathroom, so it hasn't been remodeled per se. Anytime we see that gold hardware, it's a giveaway that it's potentially an older fixture, you know, the gold on the sink. But if it's super clean, they can definitely make it work. Maybe the cabinets were painted, but everything on this side is pretty original, just very clean. Looks like they did do a new toilet here, new blinds, and then the shower has been upgraded and redone. So it was probably one of those, you know, fiberglass or porcelain tubs with either the tile or kind of the fiberglass enclosure. But they've redone it all with this really nice slate tile, and then we have that black and white hex flowery pattern on the floor, and then a really high-tech state-of-the-art system here, all kinds of knobs and sprayers, and I think they call that the car wash. Maybe they did go ahead and leave those curtain hooks up there for you if you're interested. And then back to the bedroom here, plantation shutters throughout a lot of the exterior windows here. Good sized bedroom as well. This is going to be, I think, a full bed. Not was it twin and then full. I think this is a full bed, not quite the queen, but plenty of room there. And then a good sized closet. And again, the ceilings are very tall. They potentially have changed out this light here. They didn't go all ultra modern, which I kind of like, because you kind of see everyone just go, all the door handles are black. Everything is ultra modern. And I think they just kind of worked with a nice little upgrade here and didn't have to change out everything. We just the flooring and the baseboards and the paint job, a lot of the times will do, you know, do wonders for a home. So this is going to be the second bedroom back here. You can already get a little glimpse of that view and that back patio, which we'll get out to in a minute. Again, very, very good sized bed, very tall ceilings. They change out the light again in here. And this also has its own full bath. This one has two closets, so one on either side. And then, nice big shower here, same as the other one we saw with the high-tech car wash system. And we have the slate tile. And it looks like they went ahead and replaced all this as well, which is real nice. New mirror, new vanity in here. So they did swap that out. And new toilet, it looks like. So that's going to be bedroom number two, bathroom number two. And we're going to scoot back through the house, straight across to the other side. Don't peek at the kitchen. No, I'm just kidding. It's right there. Actually, I did block it. You got to stay tuned. I'm sorry. Little closet here to the left. This is going to be the half bath powder room. Interesting, interesting kind of orientation on the toilet. I can't say that I see many toilets like this where they're like right there. I mean, it's definitely functional. It works. It's just not what you're used to. I don't know. I mean, I don't know why it's any different if it's on that wall, but it's when you come in here, you'll see what I mean. I mean, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. Functional, great, private. It's just interesting that it's right there. You like see it from the hallway, I guess, is kind of the thing. So then this little entryway here, primary bedroom to the left. This comes around to the 3-car garage. So let's take a quick peek out here. Now, I'm not sure if we'll have to do a little investigating, but you see right away we have this washer and dryer out here, the sink. Washer and dryer do look new. I don't know if these are always in the garage like this. I know a lot of the Sun City models do have the washer dryer in the garage. You can see the AC unit there to keep it cool in the summer. You insulate those garage doors, which those are. It'll keep it cool and warm, depending on what you need. You have your water heater. So it's actually fairly comfortable to do laundry if you do have the insulation and you do have a way to cool it if you need to. Looks like some sort of water filtration system here. Runs through the whole house. These are going to be your water mains, your sprinkler hookup. There is a refrigerator here that stays with the home as well. It's always great to have a garage refrigerator. And always like to point out that the small single car does have the garage door opener on this property. So what I wanted to look at and I wanted to see, there's an interesting room right here. I wonder if this was originally the laundry room and they just flipped it around. Because they have this set up as a bedroom. I don't know what this would have been. It would have been maybe a mud room. It's definitely not a bedroom. It needs a closet. Doesn't have one. Technically not a bedroom. Not sure what it could be. An office would be great. I was looking for maybe signs on the wall of construction. I'm not sure if those washer and dryer were originally out there, if this was actually the laundry room here, which seems like a good possibility to go back and look at the other models like this one. All right, so double doors here into the primary bedroom. Very tall ceilings, a nice big kind of chandelier thing in the middle of the room. Huge king-size bed. See the bathroom over there. Again, they've staged it really nice. They have a big TV here, which I would enjoy. see a little bit of that putting green out back and then some of that view. Just a teaser, we're going to go take a better look at that in just a moment. Really should come back here at night, to be honest. Anyways, I'm Andrew Guyant with Simply Vegas. If you like this tour, please like, please subscribe. If you don't like this house, please don't like my video. I don't know if you don't like me, that's fine. You don't like the video, it's bad, whatever. You can not like it. But I feel like sometimes people are not liking the homes and then they're disliking the videos. I feel like that's not really fair because I'm just trying to show you all the homes. I don't go to just like the nicest I can find. I just kind of want to show you everything on the market. So if you do not like the home, just comment below. I don't like this house, but please don't dislike the video. Reserve that for people who actually dislike me. I know everyone's not going to like me. Maybe they just don't like me. I'm speculating, but you know, it seems like when the house isn't the greatest house, I get more dislikes, and I'm feeling like it's a house judging and not a video judging. But anyways, you guys do what you want to do. Really long, big closet here. Wow, that feels like massive. It's about 12 feet long, but when I do the camera like that, it just feels like it's like we're zooming out forever. That's some wardrobe. It just keeps going. Okay, what a shot. All right, so that's going to be the closet, very large closet, plenty of storage, things to put your shoes, fold clothes, the water closet here with the door, I always point out, and that's going to be the primary bedroom. I got a little bit sidetracked about the dislikes. I apologize. Stay with me. We're headed to the main areas. Okay, here we are. So this is going to be the beautiful, modern family room. Living space, great room, whatever you want to call it. You have your couches here. These couches are not necessarily set up to watch TV. I will cry foul on the way they've set this. You can't put a big TV like that and put the couches like this. I mean, I guess you could watch TV, but I mean, that's really a poor angle. So your couch is going to be out here. I get why they do it, but you're going to be out here with your couch, but that's okay. Big TV, really modern fireplace with the colors in there. You can change the colors of the flames. You can change the color of the rocks if you want. You can take the orange out. You see a lot of purples and blues. If you like any of the furniture, typically they will sell the furniture. You could say, hey, I like this couch, and they'll tell you how much it costs. So you can just write them a check and keep it. Usually the TVs are fake, and I don't think that's any different. So don't try to buy the electronics, but everything else for the most part is for sale. And just so you know, when you do buy a home that's a resale home, anything that's attached. So here's a good example where we'd want to note this in the contract. And per the contract, technically, surround sound Bose, even though they're exterior, are attached to the ceiling. So those are part of the home. So if it's bolted onto the home, technically it's part of the home and it stays with the home in the purchase. So you know, anything that's like attached, so ceiling fans, lighting fixtures, you know, speakers, decor, anything like that that's actually physically attached to the home, you know, a shelving unit, something like that, those stay with the home. So, for example, though, if I was writing a contract for this home, I would specifically point out the Bose speakers stay with the purchase of the home, because that's one of those things where maybe the seller is not informed and they just think they can take them with them. My buyer comes here, or you come here, you go, oh, I love it. It already has the Bose, which, by the way, these are the ones I have at my house in black, and they are fantastic. The receiver's a little dated, but I don't want to change it because the surround is just insane. I've had it for about 10 years, and I don't want to change it. But these Bose are ridiculous. Anyways, I digress again. Back to the Bose, though. So these would stay with the house, and we do want to write a contract stating that those are going to stay with the property. Just a little note we write in. We you know, I always write in dishwasher, disposal, refrigerator, washer, dryer, those types of things. If they do come with the contract here, you want to write in the trash compactor there as well. I think that's a trash compactor. I kind of want to play with it, but I'm not going to. Okay, so back to the kitchen. I keep getting off on these little tangents, but let's stay focused here. Really, really nice, open, bright, kitchen here. I love the pink on the stools. I think that's a great touch. I would never choose pink for there, but it really actually works well. And you do have kind of a little bit of a pink tone, peach tone in the granite here. So you could definitely work off of that. The pink does work. Pendant lights are real nice. Just a little track light thing there. And then all of these cabinets have been repainted. It looks like the real bright white appliances. You have your microwave, your oven. Now, those are definitely aged. We would 100% write you in a home warranty. So if your microwave breaks, they come out, they fix it, no problem. Because a microwave this old, you know, it's original to the home in 2000, it looks like, or close to it when you see this, you know, yellowing. But really clean. I mean, look at that. It's cleaner than people that have had their oven for years. So it really is about use and quality. Plus, they didn't build them. They don't build them like they used to, you know. I think we're always going to say that. We're going to be in 2020 like, oh, 2020. We're way past 2020. We're going to be in 2030 and we're going to be like, hey, you know, they don't build things like they did back in 2020. But, you know, I guess it always goes that way. But nonetheless, 2000, I think they built stuff a little sturdier than they do today. I think it's just the trajectory of things. Money always gets in the way, huh? So here we go. Just a nice built-in fridge with the, it's kind of like the Sub-Zero style with the cabinets as the doors. Pretty cool. I do like that, kind of the hidden fridge. Really nice range here at the gas stovetop. And then they've mirrored out this wall here just to give the illusion that it's bigger. And then they also did something that's really smart with these mirrors. So I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. I might have to like, okay, here we go. I think that's as far as I can zoom. So that's the Las Vegas Strip right there. So what happens is they put up this mirror so you can actually see the strip lights and the sphere, everything from here, which is really cool. So you can see the strip off of the back reflection there. Awesome. Okay, back to zoom out. So this is going to be a nice little dining area as well. We have the modern light, big table with chairs. And they do have these treatments over the windows and the sliding door, which are nice. And those do stay with the house as well. Again, that's something that if the home was occupied, we would want to clarify if those come with the house or not, right? Is the owner going to take those with them? Chances are they aren't because it's probably measured specifically for that window. The chance of the new owner needing those in the right exact size, probably pretty slim. But again, we just want to be very clear. We don't like surprises. There's enough surprises we can't control. We try to control the surprises we can, so that's one of them. Surprise, those things aren't here when you come to, you know, move in. So yeah, we want to specify in the contract, in writing. That way, if they're not here, then you can always go back and be like, hey, you know, buy me some new ones or give me the old, you know, whatever it is, we need to rectify it. So that's going to be our little dining area, and this is going to be the back patio. So we have a large covered patio here. Couple built-in lights there, little fountain attached. Again, would stay with the property. All the furniture goes. Built-in grill like that would stay with the property as well. But look at this view. Holy cow. This view is absolutely ridiculous. It's 180 all the way around. So we have from the mountains looking straight south all the way over the east. I don't know how much you're going to be able to see on video because it feels like it's much smaller here, but on the ridge there, you can see where they're building up the mountain, and that's going to be kind of the Ascaya area going up in McDonald Ranch, kind of west of McDonald Ranch. And then just the golf course here, and brings us around to the entire strip view unblocked. I've seen a lot of strip views in my day, and there's a lot to be had in this city. This view right here is absolutely ridiculous. Like, it is an insane view. You can see every single building edge to edge from the stadium to what's on the far right end. I don't even know what's on the very far right, but you can see Circa and you can see downtown, like Fremont Street area, Strat. The Sphere's right there, like dead center. You could see the High Roller if you had binoculars, because it tends to just kind of blend in right there in the middle behind the Paris. And then the entire city just lights up, and then you have the Strip on top of it. That view right there is a $1 million view, just out of control. And the beauty of it is you can literally just sit in your table right here and see it while you eat. And that's just unbelievable. I've been doing this a while. I've seen a lot of things, and that's where it's at. Tell me if you want to come back here at night. Let me know in the comments. I will definitely come back here in the dark and look at this view, take pictures, and check it out. Then you can see all the way around, past north, almost to northeast. I mean, it's just, this view is absolutely out of control. And then you have the golf course down here, the canyon. You're lifted off, so you don't have to worry about anyone like coming up here. I mean, it's a 15-foot drop, and then who's going to be down there anyways? It's a good, 100 yards to the golf course. Wow. Spectacular. Thank you so much. I'm just going to stand out here and stare. We didn't even look at the rest of the backyard. I'm just so mesmerized. So there's actually a putting green over here, if anyone cares, but I'm just like looking over here. You can look at the Strip while you putt. So anyways, there's a putting green. Comes with the golf balls, apparently. This is... this is so odd. It's like a... it's turf, but it's like a green turf. It's like a putting green turf. It's got sand in it. I almost thought it was real for a sec. The texture is super interesting. But it does have sand in it, and I guess that's a really nice substitute for green, apparently. And then they have a little chipping area here. So if you like to chip, putt, looks like it just needs a little TLC, but that's pretty cool. And then we'll just look down the side here. Standard fare, some air conditioners. So again, we want that home warranty. Looks like the air conditioners are, original to the home. So you just want to keep those things going as long as they possibly can. Eventually, you're going to have to replace them at some point in time. The home warranty, can only do so much, but it will keep them running through a few summers. But yeah, eventually you're probably going to have to expend and go for it with the new AC. But anyways, I'm Andrew Guy with Simply Vegas. Thank you so much for sticking with me here. I know we talked about a lot of things. This beautiful home, it is 2,769 square foot with a 3-car garage, built in 2,000, 1,228 square foot, 3-bedroom, 4-bath with a view of a lifetime. I don't think you can get a better view. I really don't. Unless you're just like pointed there. But if you're pointed there, you're not going to get everything. It's insane. Just come see it. Call me. Thanks.